So maybe you look like this and you have dreams of looking like that. Well, you're gonna have to get leaner. But the good news is I know a thing or two about being lean. And even better, I know how to make it happen for you. And I'm not gonna need a lot of your time, I'm just gonna need your consistency. What's up guys, Jeff Cavalier, ATHLEAN-X.com. So some like to talk about losing weight, I like to talk about losing body fat because that's really what matters. And when it comes to losing body fat, there's three cons actually that determine your success. Con meaning what you consume, con meaning what your conditioning is, and con meaning what is your consistency. And as I said, it's not gonna take a whole hell of a lot of time, not this video and not what I'm going to ask you to do, but you do have to deliver for me every single day. And I promise you, this will work. It's worked with every single person I've ever applied it to. You're no different. So when we talk about what you consume, that's really about what you put in your mouth. The calories in part of the equation. I'm gonna point you in the right direction before this video is over to make sure that you don't slip that up. As far as your conditioning and the consistency, that's where I'm gonna come in here, and I'm gonna make sure that this is simple and easy to follow. But before we do, you're gonna need to know a few things. So when it comes to the scientific prescription of any cardiovascular workout, it starts with one big number, and that is your maximum heart rate. Because every effort is determined by a percentage of that maximum heart rate. So what's yours? Well, if you don't know, it's actually quite simple. Remember, I promised this would be very easy to follow. It's a simple equation of 220 minus your age. So let's say you're a 40-year-old man or woman. It's 220 minus 40 equals 180 is your max heart rate. So now your percentages are based around that. How do those play out with cardiovascular workouts? Well, it depends on how intensely you're training. And that's determined by the zone you're training in. When it comes to cardiovascular training, there's actually five of them. But as we know from the work of Dr. Peter Attia, the ones we wanna focus on are 2 and 5. And as you'll see with me, there's one more in between 3 and 4. But hold off for a second, because what these zones are determined by is the amount of effort that you're putting forth during the training. And they're based upon the percentage of maximum heart rate. Zone 2 has a 60 to 70% working zone. Zone 3, 70 to 80%. Zone 4, 80 to 90. And zone 5, way up at that 90% to up to 95% of your max heart rate. Now, what would these numbers look like in practice? Well, we can keep it really simple, right? We can just focus on the bottom number of the equation, 60, 70, 80, and 90. And if we take that 180 beats per minute, 40-year-old man or woman, then that's gonna put us in zone 2 at 108 beats per minute. Down in zone 5 here, 162 beats per minute. And in between that 3-4, where I like to call it the 3.5, we have 135 beats per minute. And again, you can see that the effort level here is going to be different. And the protocol that's going to allow you to train at these different levels is very specific. But before we go over what those look like, you actually have to know when you're doing each of these. And that's where our 7-day calendar is gonna come in really handy, because it's gonna tell you exactly what to do. So Monday, 2. Tuesday, zone 5. 3 consecutive days here of zone 2 on Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. And then you've got your 3.5 and your 5. Now, don't worry if you can't commit to this exact schedule, but I do want you to commit to two things. Actually doing it every day, and secondly, making sure that you maintain this sequence. So if you had to move, let's say, the Saturday and Sunday workouts to Monday and Tuesday, because these will be a little bit shorter and maybe you want that extra time during the work week, you can slide those over and then follow in sequence 2-5-2 and keep going that way. Whatever it is, just make sure you don't break that sequence as it wraps around. Now, as far as what you're doing, there's a time commitment here. Remember I said it wasn't gonna be that much? I didn't lie, because in the first month here that you're gonna attack this plan, you're gonna do just 15 minutes of your zone 2 workouts. That's the longest workout I'm gonna ask of you for the entire month. In zone 3.5, you're gonna do just a 10-minute workout. And here in zone 5, I'm only asking for 5 minutes. But I know you've been chomping at the bit to figure out exactly what you're supposed to do, so let's do it. The zone 2 workouts you're gonna find are very low effort, and they're actually pretty basic. You can choose here too, whether you wanna do a fast walk, or some cycling, or sit down at a rower, some swimming, and these aren't even your only choices. But the thing is, your effort will always be around the same. If you're training in that 60% of max heart rate, you're talking about that heartbeat of around 108 beats per minute. Well, think about where you might be starting. Let's say around 65 or 70 or 75, 80 beats per minute at a resting heart rate. You don't have to elevate all that much. And the way Dr. Attia describes this is, you should be able to carry on a conversation, though be a little bit out of breath while you do. And if you do this, like I said, starting off in the first month for just 15 minutes whenever you prescribe the zone 2 workout, you're doing exactly what I want you to. So now let's just jump ahead to zone 5. And I have to admit, this kind of sucks. because it's really hard. Remember, we're talking about 90% of your maximum heart rate, maybe up to 162 beats per minute at a 40-year-old person. We're still talking about high-intensity activities, though, that are very similar to the same things you were doing before, just, again, at a much higher threshold of intensity. Sprinting, a Stairmaster, cycling, or rowing. And again, these are just four examples of what you could do. But you do have to take note, because there are some things that link the two of them together, meaning sprinting and Stairmaster, because the work-rest ratio here is going to be 1-2. I'll explain that in a second. Whereas cycling and rowing is going to be more of a 1-1 work-rest ratio. So if we applied that to our 5-minute workout for zone 5 in the first month, what does that look like? Well, if you're sprinting or doing a Stairmaster, you want to put forth effort high, as hard as you can possibly go for 20 seconds. And then you're gonna rest for 40 seconds. That brings it to 1 minute. You'd repeat it in minute two, repeat it in minute three, all the way through your 5 minutes. If instead you opted for cycling or rowing, you want that 1-1 work to rest ratio. And here what you're gonna look for is 2.5 minutes of that best effort that you can pull together over the first half of those 5 minutes. In the second half, you get to kind of bring it down a few notches, back more to that zone 2 effort range. And again, just 5 minutes, just one really intense bout, followed by one equally long but less intense effort. Which brings us to that zone 3.5, my thing, right? Where I told you that we can hit the intermediate area of zones 3 and 4, training at that 75% max heart rate, to put together a workout that isn't simply just cardio-based. In other words, what we can do is create an aerobic effort through stringing together anaerobic exercises, meaning traditional strength-based exercises. And what this does is it helps to actually counteract some of the fears people have that cardio is just eating their muscle. Certainly in zone 5, high effort sprinting, we're not eating any muscle, and I would debate that even in those zone 2, we're not either. But this workout will kind of make sure that doesn't happen. And we do that with something called 5-45s, which is 5 exercises done for 45 seconds apiece, followed by 15 seconds rest. And we can put the exercises together pretty functionally so we can make sure that we're hitting the majority of our body. Remember, the more muscles that are working, the more oxygen has to be driven to those working muscles, which is going to demand a higher effort. So we start with a squat pattern, then a push-up or upper body push pattern, then a posterior chain or glute-driven pattern, then an upper body pull or posterior chain upper body exercise, followed by a lunge pattern. Now specifically, what do the exercises look like and how long are you doing them? Well, the first exercise starts off with something called a ratchet squat. Now each of these exercise pairings is gonna have a more intense version and something that is a step down or a bailout. Your job is to try to perform the intense version for the entire 45 seconds. If you can, great job. If you can't, you simply move to the bailout and complete the remainder of the 45 seconds if that happens to you. In that case, you'd be moving to this alternative called the pivot squat. Now, if you can't do that higher intensity exercise at all, then just simply start with a pivot squat and carry it all the way through for the 45 seconds. And I know there's some of you out there, and don't be discouraged. If you can't make it through all 45 seconds of even the pivot squat, you simply go for as long as you can, rest, pause your way until all 45 seconds are completed. Now, the next exercise up would start as a push-up, and if you can't do that, or your bailout option would then drop down to a knee push-up. Next exercise here is a bridge and reach over for that posterior chain, like I said, followed by the bridges if needed as far as your bailout. If not, you simply take the bridge and reach overs all the way through. Your Superman press-out exercise here would be your option to start, bailing out if necessary to a simple Superman, and then your final exercise is this grueling split squat hop. And again, if you can't make it all the way through, don't quit. Simply drop down to the reverse lunges. And again, remember, in that first month of recommendations, I said just 10 minutes of this workout, which means if you perform 45 seconds with 15 seconds rest, all the way through, that's 5 minutes. You simply do it 2 times, and your workout is done. So now where does that leave you? Well, again, right here back at the first month of doing this. And remember, I told you I'm not going to ask a lot from you. Those zone 2 workouts are just 15 minutes right now. Those zone 3.5, just 10. And over here, those zone 5, just 5 minutes. But we're going to progress because you're going to be encouraged by results, I guarantee it. If you stay consistent with this and do just that little task each day, I promise you, you're going to be coming back to this video and commenting about your progress. But in month 2, it's time to kind of push it a little bit forward. So that means the zone 2s go up by 5 minutes to 20 minutes. The zone 3.5s go up to 5 minutes to 15, and then those zone 5s go from 5 to 10. And we continue to do that over the course of the next 4 months. However, look at where we're ending here. I'm asking you for just 30-minute sessions of zone 2 and all the way down to 20-minute sessions of that zone 5. They're not long workouts, guys, But if you commit to this, remember, this is the calories out portion of the equation when it comes to fat loss. And if you start to increase the amount of effort you put forth, those calories out will start to increase. If you want to talk about the calories in portion of the equation, guys, that is nutrition. And anybody who wants to get up here, who might be starting anywhere out down here, is going to find that the greatest path here is by knowing what to eat. I actually have a dedicated video on the topic, exactly what you need to do to get lean from any body fat level. You're going to want to watch that right here. If you're looking for a complete meal plan, guys, I have it over at ATHLEAN-X.com, as well as our supplements. In the meantime, make sure you click subscribe, turn on your notifications so you never miss a video from us when we put one out. All right, guys, see you soon.